So, trainers, if you remember, the Pokemon Go Fest Chicago was a quiet blunder, but Niantic has agreed to refund all the ticket prices and refund all players with the $100 of Pokecoins. So what if I say the next time you are planning for the Pokemon Go Fest on 25th in person and purchase all the tickets and all of the stuffs, but the event got cancelled and you are not being refunded by Niantic? How you feel about that? Because new terms of services has just got that. So let's talk about the terms and conditions. The very first thing you are agreed upon, your account can be terminated at any time without notice if you breach the terms. Previously, if you breach the terms of conditions in Pokemon Go, you will get a 7-day ban, 30-day ban. But now, if you agree to the new terms and conditions, you will get a direct ban without any prior notice. No, all contribution of 8 years will be gone. Talking about the second terms and conditions, you are waiving your right to sue Niantic at court or any law. So once you agree to these conditions, you cannot sue Niantic for any further challenges you faced while playing this game. No refunds for virtual goods or virtual money once purchased. After agreeing to this new terms and conditions, you cannot ask for a refund if you accidentally purchase from the shop. Niantic can employ mechanisms to detect and recognize the cheating, including checking your device for unauthorized software. So previously, in the last year, some miners had reported that Niantic is going to get into your device. So if you agree to these new terms and services of Niantic, you are agreeing that Niantic can detect your activity and check out the app you download on your phone. That's a privacy concern here. So another clause in the Niantic terms and conditions is Niantic is not liable for any damages or losses resulting from the use of the services. So according to this, you cannot liable the Niantic company for any damages or losses while you use their services like Pokemon Go or any other game. So previously, if you remembered, a trainer in Japan got the white and black Kyurem from the Go Battle League reward, and in the next few days, Niantic has removed the white and black Kyurem from his Pokemon storage. So as per the new terms and conditions, Niantic can change or remove virtual money or virtual goods at any time without any liabilities. This is the new terms and conditions which freaks me out. You never know which Pokemon or Pokecoins Niantic remove without any prior notice, and you cannot label Niantic for that. The next one is Niantic can use your data for event features and may share it with third parties. They can use your data for their promotions and feature for the respective events. So next up is Niantic can refuse admissions or remove you from event without refund for non-compliance with terms or misconduct. So as per that, Niantic can refuse you or remove you from any event if they feel that you are misconducting. They will remove you from the location. Niantic can use your likeness and data for promotional purposes without compensation. Now, with the new terms and conditions, Niantic can use your videos related to Pokemon Go for their promotional purposes, and they will not even pay you for providing the content of Pokemon Go. So if you are a new player or returning player, you have 3 choices to log in Pokemon Go, either through the Facebook, Google, or Trainer Club, or Niantic Kits. As per the new terms and conditions of the Niantic, that Niantic is not responsible for third-party website or resources linked to the services. So as per that, Niantic is not responsible if they theft your data and they sell their data to another third party. They are not responsible for this. But many of the other companies are also have these terms and conditions to protect themselves. I don't know why Niantic is doing this, but Niantic can terminate the inactive accounts after a period of inactivity. So if you play Pokemon Go occasionally, like only on Go Fest, Go Tour, or Community Days, and rest of the time you don't play Pokemon Go, so this is a pretty reminder that you should play Pokemon Go daily so that your account will not be deactivated or terminated by Niantic. So next one is that Niantic can use the data for emergency notification and public event leaderboards. So this is what we all want from 2016. This makes the game even more competitive and more encouraging for the players. Moving further, next is Niantic is not liable for any damages resulting from third-party services affecting your use of these services. So Niantic will not be liable for getting any damages while you use these third-party app services or more. So if you are a parent or a guardian of a child and you should bring them in the in-person Niantic official meetup, be sure to take care of the child. So Niantic has the official right to refuse admission or remove minors from the events without a parent or guardian. So how many of you noticed that while playing Pokemon Go, suddenly a survey has come which will ask for your feedback in Pokemon Go. So Niantic can use your feedback and analytic data collected during the programs without compensation. So you will not get any compensation for filling out the survey and wasting your 5 minutes. If you do that, it will take much longer than it says. So be sure, if you want to skip the survey, you can skip the survey and effortlessly you can play the game as per your conditions. So there is one good thing to notice here, that Niantic has given an option to opt out from these terms and conditions. They will give you 30-day rest period once you accept the terms and conditions in the game. You have the choice either to accept the conditions, so you have the right to not accept the conditions. So let me know in the comments down below, are you going to accept the conditions or not? If you not accept the conditions, you will be kicked out and signed off from your current login to Pokemon Go. You cannot log in until you accept the terms and conditions. So then, in order to opt out from this terms and condition agreement, fans will be given an opportunity to send a mail to the Niantic official mail, and they will have to respond that I am not agreeing to the terms and conditions of your game, and they will be opt out from this very terms and condition agreement. So yeah, this is a whole lot of information I want to convey with you regarding the new terms and conditions coming soon to Pokemon Go or other Niantic games. Tell me your honest opinion. So yeah, with that being said, thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and subscribe to the new and I'll be in the next one. So until then, keep doing what you love, keep exploring. So until then, be sure to read out all the terms and conditions and choose whether to agreed or not to agreed. It's high time now. Bye.